It's been a couple of months since I published my app on the App Store, and I think it would be a good time just to open App Store Connect and look at all the numbers, like downloads, in-app purchases, how much money the app was able to make in this period, full transparency as I promised in one of my previous devlogs. And by the way, if you haven't seen one of those, a short recap. About a year ago, I started to work on an app that is now called Checker. It's a relatively simple tracker app for habits, goals, projects, whatever, just a generic tracker, right? I've started it because of three main reasons. First, I wanted to be more consistent with making progress on my side projects and some other life goals. Second, I needed an app idea that I can build by myself in a reasonable time and finally start my journey as an app developer. And third, even though there are a ton of habit trackers on the App Store, I couldn't find one that on one hand had all the features that I wanted and on the other hand followed some core values and principles that I think make sense for this kind of apps, like deep integration into Apple ecosystem, no ads, no subscriptions, fully private, this kind of stuff. So I've decided to build my own, and it took me about 9 months to finish the first version, and on July 23rd, 2024, I had my very first app on the App Store. Okay, now let's look at App Store Connect with all the data. So that's the recent state for the past months. A lot of red numbers here, but I'll explain what's going on a bit later. Now let's zoom out to the whole period the app has been in the store, which is from July 23rd to the most recent available date. I will hide the total proceeds for now just to keep some intrigue, but I will go back to it in a bit and show you the full revenue breakdown. A small tangent about this analytics that Apple provides and how naive I was while building the app. So in Checker, there is a one-time in-app purchase to local features, and right after you buy it, there is a thank you screen with my handwritten signature and a couple of words from me. I thought it would be a nice, cute personal touch. And on that screen, I'm saying something like, I just got a notification about this purchase you just made. And at the time, while implementing this screen, I thought making some money with your app is kind of important for developers, right? So surely Apple provides a real-time notifications about in-app purchases. Not sure what I was thinking. I probably forgot which company I'm dealing here with. But in reality, the best case scenario is that I see my analytics with 1 day delay, and often it's 2, 3, or sometimes 4 days. I need to wait before the analytics updates. It's just ridiculous. But anyway, let's get back to the numbers. Downloads would probably give the best overview of the whole journey from the launch where all the spikes were happening to settling into the normal day-to-day state. So in total, you can see the app was downloaded roughly 5,500 times, which is not that bad, but I also realized downloads is largely a vanity metric because there are a ton of people who download the app and delete it straight away, or they install it and never actually open it, or open it only once and forget about it. Daily active users is, I think, much more important long-term metric. I'll show it in a bit. First, I want to talk about those spikes on the chart. So Checker was in store on July 23rd, and then next day I started to post about it. Mainly it was Threads, Mastodon, and this YouTube channel. I made a one community post and also one short. The main video about the release I published a week later. So on the launch day, there was 300 downloads, and then over the next 3 days, in total, roughly 600-700 downloads. Then there was this weird spike. I didn't do anything special there. It was just a minor iOS release, and seems like Apple just gave the app a bunch of impressions on the App Store for some reason. And you see, right, the next day it went back to the usual numbers. Then on 2nd of August, I published the main video about the release, so there was a slight bump in downloads. Then there is this huge spike with over 1,000 downloads in 1 day. Which was my Reddit post that went semi-viral. I want to make a separate video about my marketing strategies and what worked in my case and what was a waste of time. And this Reddit post was like a 2-week operation to pull off, so I won't talk about it right now and will make a dedicated video. So the first couple of weeks were definitely fun, but then it all settled into more humble numbers. And that's why my overview dashboard was all red, because it compares numbers for the current month months, with the previous months, with all these abnormal launch activities. If we look now at the last 30 days, on average 10-15 people download the app every day, which to me, to be honest, feels even more mind-blowing than those thousands downloads at the start, because with those initial spikes, I was making a deliberate effort to get some attention from people, and I was expecting at least some amount of output, right? Well, these 10-15 downloads a day are kind of completely passive. It's just random people looking for a solution to their need, and they go through this app discovery pipeline without any shortcuts, like previous inputs and explanations. It's very organic, right? So it feels validating that at least something is working in terms of marketing. Now, for the metric that I said is more important long term, daily active users. So roughly 80 people use the app on any given day. And of course, it's probably not the same people every single day. Also, from what I know, this analytics doesn't take into account interactions with home screen widgets. It only counts people who actually open the main app. And I know from feedback that a lot of people use mostly checkers widgets, and I myself use it this way as well. So real daily usage might be even slightly higher. Now let me show you a chart that was really humbling when I first saw it. It's a ratio between app deletions and total installs. So in the past 30 days, 70% of people who installed the app have deleted it. And out of those 30% that's left, only a fraction of people actually use the app. Not gonna lie, when I first saw this number, it was kind of depressing. Then I did a bit of research, and turns out it's kind of a normal thing to have this ratio that high. But I also understand that checker right now misses a lot of these table stakes kind of features, like reminders, for example, and this drives a lot of deletions. So I need to cover those basics. Now, in terms of money. So for the whole period, the app has been in the App Store. 182 people bought the paid version, and in total it made $1,940 gross, which is before Apple's cut, right? Net profits are $1,330, and I would need to pay taxes on that. Here in Germany, it would be roughly 32%. So in the end, I get to keep $904, which is, of course, not some groundbreaking amounts, but it's still much, much better than I expected. So overall, I'm quite happy. Most of the purchases come from US and Germany, and I believe the same goes for downloads, only there a bit more comes from Germany than from US. Now, for the sources where those downloads come from, this is number of checkers App Store product page views broken down by source from which people land on that product page, and these are daily averages for every source. I'm a bit surprised by the App Store browse being that high. I have no idea how people can discover checker on the App Store without actually searching for a habit tracking app. If you know how this works, please let me know. Okay, let's see what else is there in terms of interesting metrics. Average retention, I think, is good. Out of all people who install the app, roughly 10% of them still use it after 1 month, which from what I read is a relatively high number in this app category. But also, as I mentioned before, it doesn't take into account interactions with home screen widgets. So some people might still be using the app, but through the widgets only, and there is no way to see that in this analytics. Let me know if you want to see some other metrics that I've missed. Those are things that I look the most at, but maybe there is something else important. Now, for the things that changed within the app itself during this time, I pushed 7 updates after the initial one. The most significant were adding an option to switch between default wide and the new compact layouts on the main screen, and also rearranging boards with drag and drop, which a lot of people requested. Then I added a way to add custom units for boards that track amounts. So now people can track, for example, number of pages they read every day or cups of coffee they drink, anything they want. And after that release, it was end of August already, and iOS 18 release was just a couple of weeks away. So I decided to focus fully on iOS 18 specific features and be there on day one, with a slight hope that Apple might feature checker somewhere, which of course didn't happen, but I still got full support for tinted home screens and also control center widgets. After that, with the new iPhones coming out, I didn't want people to lose their data in Checker, because at the time all your boards and check-ins were just in a local database in a file on your device, and if you switch to a new phone and decide to install iOS from scratch, there wouldn't be a way to transfer Checker's data from an old phone. So I decided to start working on iCloud Sync, which I wanted to have anyways. I just reprioritized a bit and moved it up my feature queue. So that was my latest release. All data is now synced across devices through iCloud. And also in that release, I refreshed the apps icon. This one works better with dark and tinted home screen styles in iOS 18. Now, in terms of future plans, there is of course a very long list of features, but in the short term, like a couple of months, there are three major priorities: reminders, board color themes, and a small home screen widget. I suspect in the new year season there will be much more people looking for this kind of apps because of the new year's resolutions. People will start new habits and hobbies, so by the time I want to make Checker a very solid competitive product, and for this, as I mentioned, I need to cover those table stakes features. So that's the plan. Let's see how it goes. I hope this kind of analytics breakdown was useful to someone. I will do another one in a couple of months when more data has accumulated, but that's it for this one. Thank you for watching. Cheers.